everyone, welcome to this class. In this class, today I explain you how to multiply fractions and reduce them into a lowest term. So let's take one question, that is from module number 1. The question is 1 upon 3 multiply 1 upon 4. This is the question given in your book. Now first thing is that how do we solve this one? First we multiply numerator to numerator. Numerator to numerator. You know which one is numerator, which one is denominator? This one is called numerator and this one is called denominator. Numerator is this one and denominator is this one. So we multiply numerator to numerator. We multiply numerator to numerator. Then we multiply denominator to denominator. Multiply these two numbers. Right everyone? One thing is that we reduce to the lowest number. Reduce to, just see, can we divide this number? Now, multiply them. 1 into 1 is 1. 3 into 4 is 12. Can we reduce 1 and 12 to each other? Because it is a 1 number, it is 1, numerator is 1. So, we cannot reduce it. And it is in a proper fraction. What do you mean by the proper fraction? Proper fraction is when the denominator is greater than numerator, then it is called proper fraction. Then there is no need to convert into a mixed fraction. What is a proper fraction? What is the meaning of proper fraction? When the value of denominator is more than the numerator, then it is called proper fraction. Now it is in proper fraction, 12 is more than 1. So we can say we cannot convert them into a mixed fraction. So this is the answer. Write the answer here. 1 upon 12 answer. This is the answer in this question. I explain you one more question to clarify. The question is 1 upon 3 multiply 3 upon 4. This is the question. As I told you, you multiply numerator to numerator means 1 into 2, 1 into 3 and then 3 into 4. Before multiplication, you just check anything which we can reduce here. Just see 3 and 3. Because we reduce numerator to denominator, not numerator to numerator. Okay, we reduce numerator to denominator. Just see 3 is here and 3 is also here. These two are the same number. So what we can do? We can cut them. Because they both are in a single table. So we cut them. What is left? 3 ones are 3 and 3 ones are 3. So what is left? 1 multiply 1. 1 multiply 1, 1. 1 multiply 4 is equal to 4. It is 1 upon 4. Again the denominator is greater than numerator. It means it is in a proper fraction. So this is the answer. No need to convert it into a mixed fraction. Okay. Is 5 upon 8 multiply 2 upon 20. So what we do next? Numerator to numerator. Multiply numerator to numerator. And denominator to denominator. Anything which we can reduce here? Just see, this 5 and this 20. These two are in a single table. Yes, 20 is a multiple of 5. So what we can do? 5, 1's a 5 and 5, 4's a 20. Further also we can do anything which we can do. Just think about it. 2 and this 8. 2. 8 is a multiple of 2. So what we can do? We can reduce these two numbers together. 2, 1's a 2 and 2, 4's a 8. What is left? 1 into 1, 1. 4 into 4, 16. Again, denominator is more than the numerator. So, this is the answer. This is a proper fraction. So, this is the answer. Now, here the question is 3 upon 4 multiply 5. Then, how do we solve this one? Here, denominator is not given to us. So, what we do here? We write down 1 in the denominator. Now, follow the steps. Numerator to numerator, multiply numerator to numerator and then denominator to denominator. Anything which is a multiple of anyone, just see 3 and 5, 4. 4 is not a multiple of 3 and 5. And so we can, what we can do? We multiply them. 3 into 5, 3 5 is 15. And 4 into 1 is 4. Now here, denominator is smaller than the numerator. Yes, so we can divide them. What? So how do we write? We divide them. 4 3s are 12. And the remainder is 3. This 3 we write in the middle. And this 3 goes here. And it is 4. Now you can check also. 3 4s are 12. And 12 plus 3 is 15. So this is the same answer. Okay. So in this way you convert it into a mixed fraction after that. So this is the answer. Question is 3 1 by 3 multiply 4 upon 5. First we convert this number. This is a mixed fraction. Convert it into a improper fraction. Then how do we convert? First we multiply them. 3 into 3, 9. Then add it to 1. 3 into 3, 9. 9 plus 1, 10. Upon 3 multiply 4 upon 5. Then multiply numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator. Anything which is a multiple of anyone, just see 5 and 10. These two, 10 is a multiple of 5. So we can reduce them. 5 into 5 ones are and 5 twos are. Now 3 is not a, 3 is a prime number, so it is not a multiple of anyone. So 2 into 4, 2 fours are 8. And 3 into 1, 3. Now they are in. Now this time denominator is again less than the numerator, so it is an improper fraction. So we divide them. 3 2s are 6, remainder is 2. This 2 we write in the middle and this 3 2 goes here and denominator will be same. So this is the answer. Now the question is 11 upon 49 multiply 2 upon 22. Then how do we solve? Every time, so we cannot write numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator. We go a little bit faster. So what we do here, we cut numerator to denominator. Just see any of the numbers. Just see 22. 22 is a multiple of 11. So we can cut them. Always you are reducing a number. You reduce numerator to denominator, not numerator to numerator. Numerator to numerator. You always reduce numerator to denominator. Okay. So 11 to 22. Now 2 and 49. These are not reducible. So what we write? First we write them. 1 into 2 and 49 multiply 2. Just see 2 and 2. These two are the same number, so we can cut them. So what is left? 1. 1 into 1, 1 and 49 into 1, 49 and 49. Denominator is more than the numerator. So the answer is in proper fraction. So this is the answer. Okay, I explain you one more question. Now the question is, so here the question is 3 upon 7 multiply 14 upon 15 multiply 5 upon 21. This time we have 3 numbers. So what we do here? We reduce them. Just see anything which we can cut here. Just see 3 and 15. These two are multiple of each other. Just see 15 is a multiple of 3. So we can cut by 3. 3 ones are 3. 3 fives are 15. Okay. Now just see 5 and 5. These two are the same number. So we can cut. 5 ones are 5 and 5 ones are 5. Now anything which we can cut here. Just see. 7, we cut 7 and 21 or 7 and 14? We cut 7 and 14 because these are in numerator and denominator. 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14. Now what is left? 2 and 21, can we cut them together? No, we cannot cut them. Now, so what next? We multiply all the number. 1 into 2, 2, 2 into 1, 2. Now multiply these three numbers also. This is equal to 21. And 21 is more than 2. So we can write the answer here only. In this question. question, the questions are in mixed fractions. So first we convert them into a improper fraction. So when we multiply them, 2 into 2, 4, 4 plus 1, 5. 5 into 3, 15, 15 plus 4, 19. It is 17 upon 19. Now think about it, what we can cut. Just see here, 5 and 5, these two are the same number, so we cut them. 19 and 19, these two are same numbers, cut them. What is left? 2 and 17, can we cut them together? No, we cannot cut them, so multiply them. So it is 17 upon, what is left? Only 2 is there. Now this time denominator is less than numerator. So what we do here? We divide them. This one. This number write down in the middle. This is the answer, so always write answer in the middle. And remainder you write down here. And it is the same number 2. Okay, you can check also 2, 8 are 16, 16 plus 1, 17 upon 2. This is the same number. So in this way, you can solve the question. Thank you everyone.